You're tuned in to Ask the Master Auto Technician. Car questions? Get answers right now. Call 850-763-0555.
James Auto Center, we fix it right, guaranteed. Beep, 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 yeah.
All right, welcome back to our second part. Before I go to Brian Armstead on here, he's calling all the way from Maryland. We're going to talk about the 2017 EcoBoost V6 engine and the Ford truck. But anyway, we're going to be talking about Ford trucks. But I got Johnny with an 87 Seville. And Johnny, what's your question real quick before I go talk to Brian Armstead about his review? Johnny, are you there? Hello, Johnny. I'm going to give you a couple seconds here. I hope maybe he might have been just listening to us instead of. Johnny, are you there? I guess.
Yes, I am.
Yay, Johnny, what is your question real quick before we have to go to Rob?
My question is, I have a 1983 Seville Cadillac.
Okay, 83.
I mean, I can't get it to start to save my life.
Okay.
My wife, right. She was headed to Lynn Haven about 3 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And it's a 30-year-old car, yeah. You know, but it's the first time it ever did something like yeah. that. And I put the new coil on it. I put the new distributor cap.
Mm-hmm.
And another guy told me I had to go get something, I think it was called like a bypass or something.
I don't know. I mean, what does it not have? Does it have spark? Does it have fuel?
Well, that's the thing. He says it's not getting any spark to it.
Okay, well, on this model car, on that engine, there's a big problem, and you're not going to believe. I learned about this from Mark Sarlo, who calls every Friday. That problem, your car had a problem with the ground going from the battery to the engine. It wasn't a good ground, and it wasn't good enough to make the car get good spark. But on that model, use a distributor, and you may. And I don't know what your problem is. It could be a distributor. It could just be a faulty ground. But I had an 83 Cadillac that kicked my butt for a long time, and it all had to do with a bad ground. My best advice, Johnny, is just please drag the car over here. You're going to spend about
an hour. I can't crank it up.
No. Drag it over here. Call a tow service. Have them tow it over here. If you're AAA, they'll tow it over here if you're a AAA member for free. But tow it over here, and let's find out what's going. You're going to spend about an hour's labor for me to tell you what I think's wrong with the car and what the problem is to fix it. And that way, then you can say, fix it, don't want to fix it, whatever. But if you got a good car, let's get the car fixed to get it back on the road. I got to get Brian Armstead. He's calling to review on a car. And let me know if that helps you out, Johnny, okay? Try to get it over here. Thank you so much.
Okay,
sir.
Thank you.
You're very, very welcome. Anna Marie, let's get Brian on there because he's calling long distance. What you got?
Brian.
Okay, Brian, is he there? Brian, are you there?
Hello. Absolutely.
Good. So I had to answer a car question, believe it or not. Sometimes I do that. Brian, tell me about this Ford truck. You picked the best, to me, the best truck out there on the market right now. I love the Ford EcoBoost engine out there. So tell me about your review, what you decided and learned on this truck you drove.
Well, it's the 2017 F-150 Raptor.
Ah.
Now, the Raptor is an F-150 variant. You know, the F-150 has been the best-selling pickup truck in America for 40-plus years.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the sales numbers are astounding for this line of vehicles. And they have decided to create an off-road version called the Raptor.
Hmm.
Based on the fighter jet, the Raptor, I believe it's the F-22 or V-22, something like that.
F-22 is right here in Tyndall. We have them right
F-22?
Here. F-22? Yeah, right here in Panama City, Florida. That's where they're stationed at.
So. Okay, very good. So the Raptor's all about performance and about the ability to do things that ordinary vehicles and ordinary planes cannot do. This vehicle, first of all, when you first walk up to it, it's a stunning presentation. It's tall like the King Ranch. It's got huge tires on it. They're LT 315 7017 all-terrain tires. They're just massive BF Goodrich tires. It's got special body cladding, Raptor body cladding. From the front, you have special LED light treatments for the Raptor.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing at the rear. The nice thing about it is that it's not hard to get in and out of the interior, even though if you're a shorter person, if you're less than 5 feet tall, you're going to have a little bit of an issue climbing up in. But they have a great assist handle on each side.
Mm-hmm.
You put your feet on the sill panels, and you pull up with your arm, and you'll be good to go. What I like about this vehicle is that it's different. It's got this turbo boost, this EcoBoost engine that gets 400 horsepower, and it's just, you know, it's just Ford taking it all to the next level. What do I mean by that?
Yeah.
I mean that traditionally, the pickup trucks that most people drive are V8-powered, you know, big old 5.7 liter, 6.2 liter V8.
Right.
And drink up a lot of gas and offer a good amount of performance, but at a cost, a fuel economy cost, that's just unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
But with this F-150 Raptor, it's got a 3.5 liter EcoBoost V6, which means that it's a turbocharged V6, mm-hmm. small displacement, turbocharged engine, 400 horsepower. You're going to go quickly. You're going to be able to pull a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
16 miles a gallon, 18 highway, 15 city. That's phenomenal for a vehicle that weighs over 6,000 pounds.
Right, and it has more torque than the Hemi engine, if I understand it. Lower RPM. I think at 1,500 RPMs, it has more torque than the Hemi has. So it has great pulling power.
I don't know that for a fact, okay. but you know a lot more. You know a lot about these vehicles as well because you work on them and you see them all the time.
I love them.
This is my first experience with the Raptor. Yeah.
Wow.
First time I've driven one.
Did it amaze you how powerful and quick it was in traffic? I mean, you know, most times you get a truck, you give it gas, it sounds loud, but it doesn't move that fast. But you push this sucker down, and it'll make the tires break loose. I mean,
yeah, it will.
Woo! I've driven them before, and if I was going to buy a truck, that'd be the truck I would want to buy. Matter of fact, I've been trying to find a used one that's about 5 or 6 years old, but no one
can't do it. Nobody's giving them up.
They're not giving them up. I'm going, what's wrong? I mean, the 2011s when they first came out, and I figured I'd find me a 2011, 2012, 2013 for $15,000, $17,000. Can't find them down here. Everybody wants them. Yeah, they're great trucks. Now, tell me more about this truck. I want to know all the details that's coming out. Does it have aluminum body? This one got the aluminum body in this one?
Yeah, it's aluminum body, a really beefy frame. I had a chance to see the frame off the vehicle at the Detroit Auto Show earlier this year. Ford had a big presentation with just the frame and all the details of the frame. You know, folks, you wonder why these pickup trucks cost a lot of money. A lot of it is the detail. This frame is a work of art.
It is.
It's a heavy-duty unit that takes a lot of technology to get it right. And this Ford frame is boxed, the cross-section boxing and the stability that they built into it, all the bracing, and it's just a phenomenal piece of technology. With all the safety attributes built into it, and you know, you throw an aluminum body on top of it, and you've got a fairly lightweight vehicle.
It's 700 pounds.
Now this off-road
less. I think it's 700 pounds less than the year before.
It's a 500 pound savings over the steel-bodied F-150 Raptor.
Good.
Now this F-150 Raptor is primarily built for as an off-road beast. I mean, they want you to be able to go and do Baja 150 or any off-road jaunt that you want, including your backyard 150. If you have a lot of property and you want to tread lightly in your own backyard, or if it's your own property and you just want to tear it up, this F-150 Raptor is capable of providing either for you. It's got a torque on-demand transfer case, which has a clutch-driven on-demand all-wheel drive system, mechanical locking four-wheel drive, so it combines all-wheel drive for fuel economy and mechanical locking four-wheel drive for off-road supremacy. You know, you got an automatic switch right here on the console.
Right.
Two high, four automatic, four high, and four low are your choices.
Okay.
Now, what I like about it when you look at it from the outside is you can see these 3-inch Fox racing shocks from the exterior. They're beautiful aluminum shocks. They've got internal bypass technology. They're oil-fed. They're just works of art. They're off-road shock absorbers. They're custom-built for this F-150 Raptor, and it allows variable damping for each wheel based on wheel travel, and it provides great off-road performance with great on-road performance. And I had a chance to take it off-road a little bit last night. We have a construction site near my home. Now, you know, I kind of did it under the cover of darkness. It was daylight outside, but I just had to do it. I mean, you know, had I been stopped, it would have been trouble, but got a couple of shots of it on this construction site. I'll post those on Instagram and Facebook a little bit later today. But a lot of features here. Base price is $48,325. You've got a $9,300 package, which is the equipment group 502A. Which includes the Raptor package, a sliding glass, power sliding glass rear window, sync telematics, a 410 front axle with torsion and differential, a 360-degree camera, blind spot intervention system with trailer tow monitoring, so you can back right up to your trailer hitch with a camera system, electronic auto temperature controls, integrated trailer brake assist, LED box lighting, LED mirror spotlight, pro trailer backup assist. That's the system which allows you to go to your hitch with a camera. Remote start, Sony CD radio, and voice-activated navigation. Bunch of other small packages, including the Raptor technology package in 1950, which includes adaptive cruise control. Base price, $48,325 as tested, $61,685. It's got $12,000 worth of options. Ooh. If you just want a looker, $48,000, okay? If you just want a looker, $48,000. If you're serious about off-roading, $61,000. You've got to spend at least $58,000 because you want that Raptor package.
Yep.
That's a $9,400 package.
It's awesome.
You know, you look at the dash, all of the things that you want to see here. You've got an off-road status monitor, which includes an inclinometer, an angle entry and departure gauge, a side tilt gauge, full instrumentation, oil pressure, oil temperature, coolant temperature, transmission temperature. The Ford driver assist package is just phenomenal. You got towing status, trailer light status, digital speedometer, tire pressure, gauge selection. You can choose the gauges that you want. I just pulled up a turbo boost gauge that I can add to my cluster. So I've replaced the transmission temperature gauge for turbo boost gauge.
1 minute.
So when I'm out there kicking these young boys in the butt with their Hondas with my F-150 Raptor, I can see how many pounds of boost that I'm running with this turbocharged V6 EcoBoost engine. I apologize for the loud noise in the background. It's raining cats and dogs here, and I'm actually sitting in the vehicle. Got Raptor seating with Raptor stitching. The only thing that's a little odd to me is the steering wheel has one single piece of leather that's an inch wide at the top that's red. And the only other thing that's red on the car is Ford Performance on the sill plates. So I thought they could have added red Raptor stitching or red Raptor names to the seats. It just is kind of an odd piece of red leather. But that's not a lot. That's just a quibble. That's not a complaint. Yeah. Folks, this vehicle is one of the reasons that the F-Series, F-150, F-250 King Ranch, F-150 Raptor, F-350, F-450. I mean, Ford has it on lock with these F-Series cars and F-Series trucks. Hats off to you, Ford. Proud American brand. You paid your way through the crisis.
Right.
And I'm hoping all the best for Ford.
Me too.
This truck is kick butt.
So you give it, how many stars you give it out of five?
I give it a strong five star. You got to pay the price for gasoline, but you're still going to be saving money over a traditional steel body vehicle. Some people lament, Chevy shows these ads with punctures in the steel. Get a Rhino liner, and you'll be good. This one actually comes with a Rhino liner, so you can have a stronger aluminum bed.
All right.
In the back, if you want to load it up with a bunch of junk.
All right, sounds good. Thank you so much. I'm against the clock, right?
You're welcome.
Here. Thank you so much. And we're going to cut, and I'm going to get Charlie on here in a minute on another section on here. Thank you so much, Sir Brian. We'll talk to you next week. I'll send this out.
Righto.
All
thank
right,
you
thank
guys.
You so much. Chainsaw Center, we fix it right.